an outstanding nuclear physicist, Professor Rotblat is known for his lifelong dedication to sustained and consistent efforts to prevent armed conflicts and to promote peaceful solutions to world problems. He has also persistently aroused the conscience of scientists for devoting their skills and ingenuity to the true purpose of science, namely promotion of the service of mankind, while at the same time adhering to ethical values. To ensure that the atom bomb, which was thought to be acquired by Nazi Germany for the purpose of world domination, will not be used, Professor Rotblat himself worked on the first atom bomb in the UK and in Los Alamos. But when it became clear that Germany was not working on the bomb, he resigned from the project and changed his direction of research work to one in which the results could be directly applied for the benefit of mankind, namely medicine.
During the First World War, when a young child, I suffered terrible privation and witnessed horrible cruelty. My opponents of war and all violence stems from that experience. As an enthusiast of science from my early years, I had a dream that science would be the vehicle to alleviate the ills in the world. Looking now back at that dream of a child, I note I'm glad to know that some of it has come true. But I am sad to note that science itself has become perverted in its pursuit, in particular in the development of omnicidal weapons. Let me now, so to the conclusion, to remind you that the elimination of nuclear weapons is only the first step in our plan. If we want to secure the future of mankind, we've got to do something much more. We have to eliminate war altogether. War must cease to be a recognized social institution. And this is something which follows strictly the Gandhi principles. These principles must be applied universally, inside and outside India. I tried to express this in my Nobel lecture. If I may, I would like just to read the last paragraph from my Nobel lecture. When I'm speaking about avoiding a world war, I said, the quest for a war-free world has a basic purpose, survival. But if in the process, we learn how to achieve it by love rather than by fear, by kindness rather than by compulsion, if in the process we learn to combine the essential with the enjoyable, the expedient with the benevolent, the practical with the beautiful, this will be an extra incentive to embark on this great task. And above all, friends, remember your humanity.